Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome back to Danganronpa. Chapter 6. Lots of information is being thrown at us. Kyoko found some information about her past, and we're investigating locked doors, because we have an all-access permission from Monokuma. Hi, Aoi.
Hey, Makoto.
Are you here to look around too? Is that what you're doing here? Yeah, I can't help but wonder about that Monokuma door. So I figured, if all the doors in the school had been unlocked, that one should open too, right?
But...
although, I couldn't bring myself to open it. Because it might explode, right? And that'd really suck. So, you open it. I'm sure she didn't mean it, but she made it sound like she was okay with me getting blown up. Thanks, Aoi. Okay, so, I guess I'll open it. Wait, let me take cover first. I don't want to get exploded. Hina raced over to a nearby desk and hid under it. Okay, go ahead. Everything will be okay, right? Alright, here goes nothing. I threw all my weight into it, but the door opened much easier than I expected. Well, this is fancy. There was no explosion, thankfully. My first impression was...
huh?
Whoa, this place is totally sci-fi! Yeah, I was kind of thinking the same thing. Oh look, there's a hatch! What is this device? It looks like some kind of control panel. It's really over the top though. Like some kind of military installation or something. Yeah, it kind of looks like a mech cockpit, right? Hifumi would probably freak out if he saw it. Cockpit? So the Monokuma room has a control panel that looks like some kind of cockpit. Then could that mean...
okay...
let's start poking it or whatever. I'm gonna start pushing buttons. Hold on, you can't just or whatever something like this! But it was too late. Hina was already jabbing away at the control panel.
Huh?
Did you hear that? Yeah, I think it came from the other room. Hina, what did you push? I'm not totally sure, but... I think it was that one. The button that says data center. Okay, I see... so, this is an interface, I assume. So you can summon Monokuma to any location in the school, and then you interface, like, you have a conversation with the students as Monokuma, right? Is that what I'm getting here? Data center? I took a good look at the control panel, and I saw a bunch of buttons, each with the name of a room next to it. And just like Hina said, there was one labeled data center. That must be the one she pushed. But the data center, that's right next door. The room we were just in, that's where the strange noise came from. I'd probably better go check it out.
Yeah.
Yes, please. I'm kind of scared out of my mind right now, so I'll just cheer you on from over here. Can I check out this hatch first, or... there's some kind of hatch on the floor. But right now I need to check out the data center. Great, fantastic. Thanks, Aoi. Did I just hear what I think I heard? So, dude. Is that Monokuma? Yeah, it's... hey! Give me all your donuts! Is that you, Hina? Aw, man, busted! How did you know?
What?
Anyway, what is this? Some kind of remote control camera kind of setup? You don't even know what you're controlling?
Hello.
Well, I mean, I can't really see anything from in here.
Found it!
Ah, guess what I found? A self-destruct button! Whatever you do, don't push it!
Too bad!
Aw, man! Were you seriously gonna push it? Anyway, I guess that settles it. The room with the Monokuma drawing on it, and the control panel inside. Okay, alright, I'm gonna go back in there, check out the hatch. Whoa, hey Makoto, what the heck was just now? Monokuma.
Huh?
What do you mean? What you were controlling just now, it was Monokuma.
Huh?
Monokuma?
Oh.
What, for real? Yep, looks like that panel definitely controls Monokuma. Which means, the mastermind has been controlling Monokuma from this room. Yeah, they were definitely in here. The mastermind has been controlling Monokuma from this room. and this control room is totally separate from the data center area with all the monitors. In other words, whenever the mastermind is controlling Monokuma, they have no eyes on the rest of the school. Kyoko's theory was right. If the mastermind has been controlling Monokuma from here, that means they've been inside the school this whole time, right? I guess that would have to be true. But if that is true... yeah. Yeah. Then the mastermind Monokuma's puppeteer really is the 16th student? No, it can't be. There's no way, right? What's wrong, Makoto? I don't like that face you're making. Oh, no, it's nothing. Okay. What about you? Is everything okay? Well, it's just... this is where the mastermind's been hiding, right? Who knows if they set up traps or something? I can't say it isn't possible, but I really hope it's not true. You want to leave soon? There's still lots of other places to check out. Yeah, good point. We can't waste all our time standing around here. Okay, you want to get going? Yeah. I want to check out the hatch on the floor! Oh, God! Let me inspect that- Okay, fine. As soon as the door to the data center was closed, I heard a strange sound. What was that? The door! It just locked on its own! What? My hand shot out to grab the doorknob. You're right, it's locked, but why? You were hiding in the hatch, weren't you? God. Of course it's locked, because the data center is now restricted! Monokuma!
Just a second!
Hey, no fair! You can't just go around restricting whatever you feel like!
Hey,
it's for your benefit! Because if that room stays open, I won't be able to move around! Imagine how depressed everyone would get if the school mascot just up and stopped moving! Then, that room...
Yep.
As you may have guessed, that's where my controls are! So right now you're being operated by someone in that room?
Yes, indeed! You're a liar!
But that doesn't make any sense! We were just in there and we didn't see anyone! Oh, you didn't, did you? Are you sure you were as thorough as you could have been? Owie. Did you happen to check a certain suspicious hatch? No way! The hatch on the floor? Now, would this dialogue change if I checked the hatch first instead of the control panel? Because if it does, then I would have just... I wish I saved. That was your one big chance and you blew it!
Too bad!
Of course, that hatch can't be opened from the outside anyway, so whatever. Now then, this room is officially restricted, so no more investigating. I'll be relying on you guys to tell the others. Peace? Monokuma said peace. He's gone, but... was he telling the truth? The mastermind was hiding in there? In fact, if you think back to when we got locked out of the control room, that proves it for sure.
Huh?
Then, when I said we should leave, well, that hatch couldn't be opened from the outside anyway, right? So it's not your fault.
Sorry.
Anyway, we don't have to let it get to us. We have to stay positive and make the most of the time we have left. You're right. If there's one thing I'm good at, it's keeping my If there's one thing I'm good at, it's not keeping my tongue moving. It's keeping my body moving.
Okay.
I'm gonna run around and tell everyone what we found here. Nice! You got me all motivated again!
You got it!
Okay, I'm out. See you later. Hina took off at a full sprint. And I have to do what I can too. That's the only way forward. Gotta be methodical about this. One by one, actually. Did I miss anything? Fourth floor headmaster, data center, fourth floor, Monokuma, second floor of dorms, I checked that. Headmaster's room, bio lab. Okay. And then garden and dojo, so it all culminates in the fifth floor. This is like an Oval Office type deal, my god. I've heard an awful lot about it, but this will be my first time seeing it for myself. Ah, Makoto. It's you. Oh, Byakuya. What do you have for me, champ? Well, you came to the right place this time. Would you like to see something interesting? What do you mean, something interesting? Take a look at this. It was on top of that pathetically ostentatious desk. Class 78 student registry? Okay. So, if I'm interpreting this correctly, there were 77 other classes before this one. How long has this school been in operation? How long has this plan been in operation? And who has been masterminding this for 77 classes, 78 classes? It contains profiles for all of us, and Mukuro.
So in other words...
Apparently class 78 refers to us. Wait, when we found Mukuro's profile in Kyoko's room...
I see.
That's right. It also mentioned class 78. This must be where Kyoko got that page. And since the rest of our profiles are listed in there along with hers...
In other words...
There can be no doubt. Mukuro was a student here at Hope Speak Academy, just like the rest of us. Mukuro Ikusaba, the 16th high school student. That must be how Kyoko learned about it. But it seems that Kyoko was in a hurry. What do you mean? I'm talking about when she stole it. The uneven tearing, the way the paper had been crumpled, she must have been in a hurry. Well, since she snuck in to get it, I'm sure she wanted to get out as fast as possible. But what's your point? She was in so much of a hurry that she only got the first page. The first page? Correct. Mukuro's profile actually contains two pages. What?
So in other words...
When it comes to this profile, there was more information about Mukuro that we still didn't have. What kind of information is it? Why do you ask me to explain every little thing? You can read, can't you? It seems to be some sort of detailed report put together by the headmaster himself.
Interesting.
I don't know what kind of man he was, but I'm glad he left us such an interesting clue. I was half listening to Byakuya as I skimmed through the report. Mukuro reappeared suddenly, and in the background an entity floats, close but just out of reach. The entity known as the Ultimate Despair. What? Right now I can't be sure if this is a single person or some kind of group. Whatever it is, Mukuro definitely has some sort of connection to it. I have a bad feeling about all of this. I need to push forward with my research into the Ultimate Despair. And I need to pay attention to Mukuro's behavior, too. This is just my gut feeling, but I think she's dangerous. Despite the countless battles she must have gone through as a member of Fenrir, when she entered Hope's Peak, she didn't display any signs of battle wounds or scars. That fact alone proves her tremendous skill in battle. Naturally, I want to believe in her. She's one of my students, after all. But if I decide she's a danger to the other students, I will be forced to take all reasonable measures. Mukuro was a part of the Ultimate Despair. I don't think there can be any doubt about it now. But wouldn't that mean Mukuro and the Mastermind were allies? So why? Why would they kill Mukuro? Plus, even the Headmaster seemed to be afraid of what Mukuro was capable of. They would have had to take her completely by surprise to kill her like that. Or maybe it means the Mastermind is even stronger than Mukuro was.
What?
What's wrong, Makoto? Huh?
That's fine.
You seem to be lost in thought, but I should probably point out one other thing. There's another important bit of information within that file that you should note. What is it? Did you notice the picture in there? A picture of a girl perhaps you've never seen before. A girl who seems to be included as part of our class 78. That should be enough for you to figure out who the girl is. And further information about that girl is included in the file. 5'7", 97 pounds, and it even lists her vitals. 31, 22, 32. She seems very, very light. 97 pounds? For 5'7"? That's... Wow, okay. Well, what do you think? What do I think? Are you asking me, like, if she has a nice body?
Stop talking.
You hopeless idiot. What I'm trying to tell you is maybe you want to keep that in mind for later. Maybe you'll make your way back to the corpse, and maybe you'll think, oh, could that mean... Wait, is he trying to say... That is not Mukuro. She's very tall. She's not 5'7". Okay. And the fake nails, like, come on. There's a chance the body isn't actually Mukuro? Is that what he's saying? Personally, what I'm thinking seems all but impossible. But it wouldn't hurt to confirm, right?
It's all clear now.
That's what I was trying to say. What you do with that information is your business. So I'm back to being Byakuya's errand boy. Okay. Oh, and one last thing. It's a bit of advice from me to you, so I just suggest you pay attention. Advice for me? You seem to be getting along with Kyoko quite well. It's not that we're getting along, she's just done a lot to help me. Well, don't put too much faith in her. Huh?
In other words...
The cost of that faith might be more than you can afford. What are you saying? Just what I think. Call it a hunch. A hunch? But my hunches tend to be proven right. The advice is free this time. Take it or don't, as you will. I'll keep it in mind, thanks. So, could it be possible that Kyoko's revelations about her family could hinder her investigating abilities? And maybe she'll slip up during the trial and actually, like, tell some false information or something like that. Throw the whole trial off, eh? There are documents scattered all over the floor. Somehow it makes me feel anxious. Class 78, student registry. Apparently that's us. It has profiles on me and everyone I met at the beginning, and Mukuro. Just like us, Mukuro was apparently a new student here at Hope's Peak. Mukuro Ikusaba, part of the Ultimate Despair. Which means her and the Mastermind should have been allies. But then, why would the Mastermind kill her? Weren't they friends? Just because you're allies doesn't mean you're friends. There could be a good reason for betrayal. There are trophies and even a shield in the display case. The bookshelf seems really well made, and it's filled with files and thick books. Nothing else in here but the screen and the surveillance camera, and those aren't of importance anyway. So don't put faith in Kyoko, eh? By that, does he mean you can't rely on Kyoko? Alone? You have to think for yourself or something like that? Should I investigate this one more time? See if there's anything new? Eye for an eye. Let's check out the bio lab, since that theoretically should be unlocked. What is it with this long, ominous hallway? What is the purpose of this? Or am I overthinking it? Well, here I am in the bio lab. It's so cold. It's like, abnormally cold. I feel like I'm in a giant refrigerator. Seriously, why is it so cold? So cold. Why is it so cold in here? That's the first thing I need to figure out. Alright. Are you freezing to death? Camera, screen. Some kind of weird machine or something built into the wall. And on the left side, there's a bunch of glowing blue lights. But on the other side... There's some kind of weird machine or something built into the wall. I've seen something like this before. That's it. I've seen this kind of thing in horror movies and stuff. It's a fridge for storing dead bodies. Does that mean this biolab is actually a morgue? I should probably take a closer look around. So is this where all the dead is this where Monokuma puts all the dead bodies? There's a stack of tarps here. I've been seeing a lot of those things lately. Wait a minute. The tarp came from here, didn't it? And the biolab was locked before, which means the Mastermind had access to this room. So, yeah, that confirms that the killer wasn't the 6 alive students. The ones on the left. The right-hand lights are off. So these okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9? Wait. 2, 4, 6, 8, 9. 9 people. 9 plus 7 is 15, right? I can't do- No, it's 16! What am I- Oh my god! Yeah. Math class was not a fun time for me, evidently. So, this is the current, lineup of students, right? So, what happens to the bodies after the last class? What am I saying? Should I investigate this? Okay. Oh, there's some kind of booklet here. It looks like an instruction manual. We offer an eco-friendly alternative to standard dry ice for all of your cadaver needs. In addition to the germicidal lamps, we also provide an ozone generator for the removal of ethylene gas. Simply insert the cadaver and the blue light will let you know when the automated systems have activated. Temperature and humidity levels will be adjusted automatically for optimum settings. With our system, anyone can keep a body fresh as a daisy for as long as you need. In the unlikely event of a problem, the red light will activate and an alarm will sound immediately. The exterior is stainless steel, and we do offer an optional leather upholstery upgrade package. This is the instruction manual for the fridge? Well, looking around, I think I get it. It seems clear to me now. There's some kind of makeshift morgue. So the headmaster's body is not here. This is reserved for the students, right? So these bodies are being kept fresh. It looks like it's set up so that when a slot is occupied, the blue light comes on. Which would mean inside each slot lit up in blue, another one of the victims is... Okay, so... Okay. I can't let my emotions take control right now. There's only one thing I can do for everyone who's died, and that's defeat the mastermind. And to do that, I have to continue my investigation. I don't have any other option. Well, let's check where I've been. Headmaster, yes. Biolab, yes. Data center, yes. And dorms, yes. So, okay. Dojo and garden next. Hi, Toko. Oh, Toko. So this is where you were.
What do you want?
Am I so disgusting you want me out of your sight? No, that's not it at all. I just thought maybe you'd find a clue. Well, I haven't. I didn't find anything. Not one single clue. I figured since this place was related to the case, it would have to have something, right? But there wasn't anything out of the ordinary here. Give it back! Give it back! Give me back my precious time! Calm down, Toko.
What's your problem?
Don't tell me to calm down! Do you have any idea what I'm going through right now? When everyone finds out, they're gonna call me useless. Good for nothing. Nobody's gonna say that. Master will. I'm not sure I can disagree with that. I don't want that. I'm sick of always being looked down upon. Why wouldn't everyone accept me? Well, I don't think there's any clues in here, so maybe I'm gonna get going. How do you know that, Makoto? Have you looked in the locker lately? There's a bunch of wooden lockers in here. We found a clue in here, but it was just the mastermind's attempt to frame Kyoko. I can totally imagine Sakura out here using this to train. Suit of armor's on display is extremely Japanese. Okay, well, okay. That's fine. To the garden, then. Piece everything together, I assume. The body's gone. Thanks, Monokuma. Where'd you put it? Wait. 7 of the morgue slots were unoccupied. Hang on. I'm gonna do some quick recollection here. Alright, so the dead people right now are Sayaka, Leon, Chihiro, Junko, Taka, Hifumi, Celeste, Sakura, Mondo, and Mukuro, question mark. And the alive people are Aoi, Byakuya, Makoto, Kyoko, Hiro, and Toko. So if 6 people are alive, why are 7 of the morgue slots unoccupied? Huh? Huh? It's gone. Makuro's body. It's not here? It was eaten by the plant! I don't know. The Monokuma flower. Is it true? Does it really appear? Okay. Maybe she's in the chicken coop. No? Okay. Honestly, I'd be kind of terrified if there were more than that. Sprinklers. Sprinkler control panel. They're set to turn on at 7:30. Maybe the body's inside the tool shed. Don't tell me that's the case. That wouldn't make any sense at all. I better check just to be sure. I didn't find anything even close to a dead body. But if it's not in here either, then it must be... Could it be in the biolab? But corpses aren't the only thing I need to check in here. There's one other thing. That tarp. A tarp played a key role in another case, so I better look into it. Not the lawnmower, you dumbo. The killer used the tarp to keep the sprinklers from getting the body wet. Which means the killer might have left some clue behind here. Huh? Why am I getting so cocky? I know nothing. I didn't notice this before, but there's a small stamp on one corner of the tarp. It says Biolab? Then this originally came from the Biolab. That's all I really needed to check here. Trial time? Since I've fulfilled all my objectives, I suppose it is trial time.
This is a school announcement. Is everyone working hard? Is your investigation coming along nicely? Well then, since you're all giving it your best, your generous headmaster will give you a little hint. For those of you who are interested, please make your way to the gym ASA possible.
Why would you not be interested in a hint? What? Now he wants to give us a hint? It's suspicious, there's no doubt about that. This could be a trap. But even knowing that, he said to go to the gym, right? And it just teleports me to the gym. Great, fantastic. Hi, where have you been this entire investigation? Oh, hey, Hiro. Makoto! Why'd you act so surprised? Oh, no reason. You heard Monokuma's announcement, right? Are you here to find out what he has to say? I just did, actually. I'm on my way out. You already talked to him? What'd he say? Listen, sorry, but I gotta go. Hiro, wait! There was no point in trying to stop him. He ran off like a frightened animal. Hiro? It was like he was trying to avoid me. I was hoping to talk to him about the notebook I found in the locker. Has he been hiding something this whole time? Yes, he's connected to the locker.
I am Monokuma!
So Makoto appeared alone in that cutscene. So is this a specialized hint? Is this hint unique to each person that walks in? Hello, welcome, hello! Are you ready for your final hint? Well, it just so happens to be in the envelope on the ground in front of you. The envelope? This must be the envelope. And just so you know, I won't be answering any questions about what you find inside. What? Don't worry, just get on with it. Monokuma's cryptic words didn't make me feel any better, but I picked up the envelope and opened it. What I found was a single photograph. Okay, now, where's Makoto? He's not in here. That's strange. Oh, they all look so adorable. Look at Mukuro. Look at her. She's so thin. What does she eat? There's Kyoko in the back. There's Toko. There's Aoi, Byakuya, Chihiro. Aw, Chihiro looks so adorable. I know he's a guy, but I just want to kiss him. Junko's face is being obscured by Kiyotaka's hand. Or arm. Why? Celeste is in the back looking like she doesn't want to be there. This is adorable. It featured a bunch of faces I recognized extremely well. It was everyone who'd come to Hope's Peak at the same time as me. Wait, but there's someone behind Sayaka. She's the only one I don't recognize. Wait, that's not true. I do recognize her. That's right. When Byakuya and I were in the headmaster's room and we looked at that file. Mukuro Ikusaba? Then this girl is... What? Why? Why is Mukuro here with everyone else? And even more than that... Just having everyone here pose like this is weird enough by itself. And we're all wearing matching uniforms. I don't remember anything like this. And now that I'm looking at it, it's not even everyone. I'm not in the picture. I'm the only one not there. The picture has all 15 other students, but not me. Did Makoto thoroughly check that student registry? Was he actually in there? Is he actually a student? But I guess that makes sense. After all, I don't remember ever taking a picture like this. I went to junior high with Sayaka, but the first time I met everyone else was when I arrived here at Hope's Peak Academy. So it's natural for me not to be in this picture. But what's definitely unnatural is that everyone else is in this picture. I thought everyone was like me and didn't know each other until they got here. But if this picture is real, then could that mean... Could it be everyone else? And just me? Everyone here except me is... How long are you gonna keep up this rambling soliloquy of yours, Hamlet?
What are you gonna do?
You're kinda getting in the way standing there, you know? So, I mean, get out. But... I told you, I'm not fielding any questions!
Unbelievable!
What kind of mystery would this be if I gave you all the answers? That'd be totally out of left field! I guess that means he's done talking. Damn it! What the hell? What the hell? So in the end, all I found in the gym was even more confusion. And with that confusion in hand, I left the gym dejected. So I'm assuming Makoto was the last one to get the hint. Everyone else already got theirs by the absence of envelopes. So could it... If this information was meant for everyone, everyone would have been there, and Monokuma would be like, "Hey, everyone, here's the picture." But so everyone else has vital information that's unique to them, right? So I'm gonna have to rely on everyone else for this trial. So how does that count as a hint? It just made me even more confused. Is that what Monokuma was going for? Did he put together a fake photo just to confuse me? Maybe Makoto was the one taking the picture. Aha! Yeah! But it all looks so real, so full of life. How could anyone fake that? Which would mean everyone but me. Maybe I should just ask everyone directly. That should clear all this up. No, I have to clear all this up. Okay, so where do I go? Where is everyone? Should I recheck the second floor dorms to see if Kyoko is still there? Is this door open? Okay. Well, you're gonna have to go in there again, Makoto, because, you know, a trial's coming up. Oh, Makoto. There's all kinds of stuff I want to talk to her about, but I'd better give her some more time. That's fine. That's fine, let's find someone else then. I don't know where they'd be. I wish they'd show up on the map so I can discern where they are. Hey, what up, Aoi? So this is where you've been hiding. Listen, I was hoping to talk to you.
Oh!
Makoto!
Okay, alright.
So two people are now freaking out about Makoto's very existence, it seems. Sorry, gotta go. What? She ran off so fast I didn't even have time to ask her to stop. Hina, why? Why won't you talk to me? What the? Let's go to the other floors then. Hiro, what are you doing here? Hey, Hiro. Makoto, what's going on with you? Every time I see you, you freak out like that. Sorry, but I'm in a big hurry. Once again, he ran off like a terrified rabbit. Hiro, what's wrong? I still wasn't able to talk to him about the notebook I'd found. It was like he was avoiding me. Like he was afraid of me. Why? Do they think I'm the mastermind? Do they think Makoto is the mastermind? God. How weird would it be for someone completely average to be the mastermind? Then again, I don't know anything for sure. Okay, I guess the important event was in the biolab. I decided to visit the biolab one more time. And the first thing I saw when I got there was her, passed out. Again. Huh? Toko? Ah, you're inspecting the body! It's open! Oh, but Toko! I need to check on my lovely little friend here. Toko, are you okay? No. No! She's not dead, is she? Check her pulse, you imbecile! Hello again, my friend. Ah! It's cold! It's super cold! It's so cold, I think I might catch cold! If you keep taking naps in places like this, I'm sure you will. What? I was asleep? Ah, I must have fainted again.
Uh-huh.
I bet you were standing there staring at me, getting all excited, weren't you? No, I wasn't.
Have you reached that certain age?
Oh, then what? Hot and bothered? Straight up horny? Okay, so why did you pass out? I don't know. Last thing I remember was me just waking up just now. What'd you do to Mr. Morose? Oh, that's right, your memory stops and starts each time you switch. Bingo bazinga! We share some base knowledge, but our memories are very much separate.
You SOB!
And don't say it like it's a bad thing. It's a blessing as far as I'm concerned. Cause even if she forgets something, I totally remember.
Yes!
So it's like double the memory. No, it's more like half. Good, this comes into play at some point. But all I want to know right now is, where's my little darling? Tell me now or I slit your throat. I don't know. I'm sure Byakuya is around somewhere doing his own investigating.
Yes.
By himself? I assume so.
Oh, I'm on fire!
I knew it. I totally knew it. I'm a total pro when it comes to all things master. Anyway, I gotta hurry. I can't even imagine how lonely he must be right now. Toko shot off, her eerie laughter echoing behind her. Oh, I totally forgot to ask you about the picture. Well, there's no point asking a Genocide Jack anyway. Besides, I have more important things to do right now. Why did Toko faint? There's gotta be some reason for it. Listen, dumbass. Oh, what? Hello? The fridge, it's open. But I'm sure they're all shut tight last I was here. That must be why she passed out.
Right.
You just appear like a shadow. My god. She faints so easily. Kyoko.
Makoto.
It's getting late, isn't it? Are you okay?
Indeed.
I'm sorry if I made you worry. No, you don't have to apologize.
Listen.
About this room. Oh yeah, it's...
It would seem...
It's a morgue. Yeah.
I knew it.
I suspected as much. And Toko must have looked inside the fridge, seen what was in there, and... Well, there you have it. You knew she'd fainted?
Indeed.
I was on my way here when Genocide Jack came running past me. I assumed she must have sneezed, but once I got inside, the real reason became clear.
It would seem...
I imagine she came here to investigate, and when she opened the slot there, that's when she saw the body inside and dropped like a bag of rocks. Why has everything got to be so difficult with her?
Anyway...
We should close it up. Don't want to leave it hanging open like that. Yeah, good idea.
Makoto.
Give me a hand with this. Kyoko approached the fridge, hands outstretched. But suddenly, she stopped. What's wrong?
Listen.
Maybe we should wait a second before closing it. How come? Because Mukuro's body is in here. Mukuro's corpse? Mukuro's body is inside the fridge?
I see.
Just like every other time, the mastermind probably brought it up here while we were in the class trial. The mastermind did it? Because they assumed we wouldn't be doing the class trial over again, I guess.
So...
You may be right. Either way, now we can finally get a good look at the body. Oh, that's right. Kyoko didn't get a chance to check the body during the last investigation.
Makoto.
I need to do my own examination of the corpse as soon as possible. I'm going to find a clue this time, and I'm going to grab the mastermind by the tail. Okay, so what should I do?
So then...
Why don't you just wait over there? I'll let you know as soon as I'm finished. Just wait over there? That's it? It's a fridge meant for storing dead bodies. Can't do it, I can't look inside. Your squeamishness is hindering your investigating ability. I should ask Kyoko about that group photo. After all, she's in it too. Don't let me interrupt your investigation, but I wanted to talk to you about something. What is it? It's about that announcement Monaco made earlier. You mean the one about a hint or something? I didn't take him up on the offer. Why not?
Because...
The only reason he'd give us a hint at this point would be to confuse us, to cloud our judgment. I can solve this mystery on my own, without whatever hints he may have to offer. That's a good point. I wish I could go back and do the same thing, but what's done is done, I guess. Standing here looking at her. I don't think she's hiding anything from me. Is she right? Did the mastermind forge that picture as a trap to confuse us? That's gotta be it. There's no other explanation. So, Toko... No, wait, Genocide Jill didn't freak out when I talked to her. Kyoko didn't freak out when I talked to her. So that means they both don't know of the photo. Are you done yet? I should ask Kyoko about that group photo. Same conversation, eh? Okay, that's fine. It's a fridge meant for storing dead bodies. Can't do it. Alright, well... I've already looked through the instruction manual, more importantly. You know, I think I've seen a tarp like this somewhere before. Ah, it's the same one as I found in the garden tool shed. And if I remember, that tarp... It had a stamp on it that said BioLab. And that's the tarp that was used to help camouflage the murder in the garden. At some point, someone got it from the BioLab and took it over there. Update! Wow! But these ones aren't.
It would seem
the blue light comes on when the slot is occupied. So when someone's in there, the blue light comes on. Looking around the number of lights that are on, including Mukuro's, there's 9 in all. 9? 9 lights? Okay! I know who's dead! Sayaka, Leon, Chihiro, Junko, Taka, Hifumi, Celeste, Sakura, Mondo, and Mukuro? Question mark. Okay, that's 9. Okay, Makoto, I'm done. Already? Geez, that was fast.
Indeed.
Anyone can do good work if they go slow. In that spirit, I'll make my report brief. So, did you find anything?
Indeed.
I paid careful attention to the wounds and the traces of blood, and it seems highly likely that the stomach wound and blow to the back of the head were inflicted after death. So, it was the bomb that killed her? No, it wasn't. It wasn't. So... Really? The burnt tissue made things a little difficult, but I'm completely confident in my findings. So that means neither of those were the fatal injury, right? Then what was the fatal injury? Due to the explosion, okay. They were, however, dead before the blast. The victim had been stabbed. They had also been struck in the head. Yeah, it doesn't specify the time that they died. This game plays me like a damn fiddle. Body was covered with other wounds, but these were at least several days old. So was this body just sitting in the morgue, and then someone extracted it and then played with it a little, using the knife and the bomb and the blow to the head? So was Makura dead before all of this? The only other option is those other wounds, but the file said they were old.
Is that right?
Where does it say that they're old? Huh?
Because
all the Monokuma file says is that they were inflicted at least several days ago. I guess I don't see the difference.
Wrong.
Well, the difference is immense, considering the impression they give.
Listen.
But you seem to be equating several days old with simply old.
However...
But that doesn't quite follow logically. Old wounds makes it sound like they've been there forever, like they're not related to the murder. Are you saying they are? But we all got the Monokuma file right after she was killed, right? So if the wounds were at least a few days old, there's no way they could have had anything to do with it. Not necessarily.
So then...
But what if Makura herself wasn't killed within the last few days? What?
At the very least...
Certainly you can allow it as one of the many possibilities, can't you? One of many?
Right.
A detective doesn't have supernatural powers. There's no way to predict the answer from the beginning. Instead, the ideal detective begins by imagining as many possible scenarios as they can.
In other words...
They envision these possibilities without prejudice, without bias, using only their logic and common sense. Then, as they investigate, they test what they find against each of those possibilities. Of course, me telling you this doesn't mean you'll be any good at detective work. But beyond using that to solve this particular mystery, you should keep it in mind for the future. Several days old doesn't necessarily mean old. I wish I had the ability to read Makura's profile in depth, like that second page.
Hey.
So if there's anything else you'd like to know about the condition of the body, now's the time. Come to think of it, there was one thing. Earlier, when I was looking at Makura's profile, it listed her height and weight.
So...
5 foot 7 inches, 97 pounds. Vitals were... 31, 22, 32. Did I get all that right? Do you remember all that? They are indeed consistent with the corpse, so okay, really. So then...
Indeed.
And don't forget about the Fenrir tattoo. There's absolutely no mistake.
Indeed.
Our victim in this case is, without a doubt, Makoro Ikusaba.
And?
Is that all you wanted to ask? Yeah, I think so.
So then...
Then it looks like we have to no further business with Makuro's body. Let's get going. It's kind of chilly in here. Wait, are we not going to put the body back? Don't you think it's kinda sad leaving it out like this?
Why?
Sad? Did you forget? She was our enemy once. A part of the ultimate despair. But she still got killed. She's still a victim.
Hey.
Have you ever heard the phrase, you reap what you sow? Well, yeah, but still. You really are naive, you know that? It's really quite appalling. But she could have abandoned me. But she decided to help me instead. So for someone like that, what does it mean to be naive?
So then...
I think we've done all we can do here. Back to our separate investigations, yes? Hold on. I still have one more thing to do. Something I need to talk to Kyoko about. I need to ask her about the pocketbook I found in that locker. If I don't do it now... Hey, Kyoko. I did have one last thing. I know I shouldn't, but I feel like I have to ask.
What?
Go ahead then. Out with it. Have you really not seen your dad even once since you got here?
What? So...
What do you mean? Well, you know all those lockers on the second floor of the dorms?
Indeed.
But to get into any of those lockers, you'd need the handbook of whoever the locker belongs to. Actually, I managed to get them open using that emergency handbook.
I see.
The one you found in the headmaster's hidden room.
And?
Did you find anything worthwhile in the lockers? I found a pocketbook, and after looking through it, I think it must be your pocketbook.
Why is that? Because...
Like I said, only the locker's owner should be able to get into it, right? I can't imagine those lockers belong to any of us. After all, we only got access to that area just recently. What I'm saying is, there's no way I could have had access to any of those lockers. And if I did have a pocketbook, why would I bother putting it in a locker? Everything you just said makes perfect sense, but there was something written inside. It was about the headmaster. About your father. Well, this could be like a deviation or like a tool of deception, intended to throw you off track.
What? If that's true...
Could that mean... that video is real too? Ooh. Ooh! We're going back to the videos! Video?
Makoto.
I think everything's finally starting to fit together to reveal a cohesive picture. Although, I'm afraid that picture might be worse than anything we could have imagined. What are you talking about?
I
need to go investigate those lockers, right now. I need to confirm what you just said with my own two eyes. Let me give you the headmaster's handbook, that way you can-
So...
That won't be necessary. If I'm right about this, I shouldn't have any problem opening the locker with my own handbook. After all, it would seem that it's my locker. Your locker?
Makoto.
If you watch this, it'll all make sense. A DVD. Class 78 Urgent Interviews? What? And it says Class 78 Urgent Interviews.
So...
I found it in that hidden room, after you left.
Anyway...
I don't have time to explain exactly what I think it means, so just watch it and see for yourself. I think you'll realize exactly what it means. You'll understand why you found my pocketbook in a place none of us have ever seen before. None of this makes any sense right now. But I guess that means there's some important clue on this DVD. How many truth bullets do I have? Oh, and now it's my turn. Do you have a second to listen to me ramble? Ramble?
In other words...
So as it turns out, the arrangements I'd made didn't stick. What I mean is, I'm less and less sure of everything. Even my own feelings. You're talking about your dad, right? I can never find the answers to the questions I wanted to ask for the rest of my life. And all because of the mastermind.
However...
But there's one thing I am sure of. When it comes to the mastermind, there's no room in my heart for forgiveness.
I
swore to destroy the mastermind. This is just one more reason to follow through on that. Kyoko's eyes burned with the fire of determination. The determination to defeat the mastermind. It's strange to be confronted with his death and suddenly feel this way. I couldn't care less if my father had found happiness.
Why?
So why is it? Why does it bother me so much to know how he suffered? It's ridiculous. There's just no understanding it, I guess. Like Byakuya, are you caught up in the logic of everything and you refuse to acknowledge your emotions? She let out a small laugh as she said it, but her smile was filled with sorrow.
Whew.
So that's it for my rambling. There's still much to do before I can consider my task complete. Yeah, you're right.
Hey.
But keep this in mind. There is only ever one absolute truth. Whether that truth serves justice or suffering. Whether it's the greatest truth or the worst. What do you mean?
Makoto.
Even if the truth you uncover is filled with hopelessness, you still can't give up hope. Absolutely not. Because all I can do is keep moving forward. That's pretty much all I'm good at, you know? Indeed. Sorry if that was strange.
So then.
Anyway, I need to get going. I'll see you at the class trial. Leaving behind that final farewell, Kyoko was gone. I better get going myself. Got that DVD from Kyoko. I should head to the AV room to check it out. Kyoko said something about hopeless truth. But no matter what happens, I won't lose hope. Even if it's the worst truth in the world, I can't afford to lose. I may have let this episode drag on for longer than intended, I'm very sorry about that. Thank you very much for watching, that was Danganronpa True Happy Havoc. It is available on Steam and the Vita for $30, the sequel Goodbye Despair is also available on Steam and the Vita for $30. Please pick them up if you can, because they are very, very good games. Can't say anything about the second one, of course, but the first one is fantastic. Thank you very much for watching, I will see you next time. Toodaloo.